This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Geary Act was a United States law that extended the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882 by adding onerous new requirements. It was written by California Congressman Thomas J. Geary and was passed by Congress on 00000001892-05-05-000 May 5, 1892. The law required all Chinese residents of the United States to carry a resident permit. A sort of internal passport. Failure to carry the permit at all times was punishable by deportation or a year of hard labor. In addition, Chinese were not allowed to bear witness in court, and could not receive bail in habeas corpus proceedings. The Geary Act was challenged in the courts but was upheld by the United States Supreme Court in an opinion by Justice Horace Gray, Fong Yu Ting v. United States, 149 U.S. 698 13, South Connecticut 10-16 37 Led 905-1893. Justices David Josiah Brewer, Stephen J. Field, and Chief Justice Melville Fuller dissenting. Contents 1. Background 2. The Act 3. Reaction 4. See also 5. References. Background. Chinese immigrants came to the U.S. in large numbers during the California Gold Rush and in the 1860s when the Central Pacific Railroad recruited labor to build its portion of the Transcontinental Railroad. Once gold became more scarce and labor more competitive, white hostility to the Chinese as well as other foreign laborers intensified in the West. This hostility eventually led to the passage of anti-Chinese immigration laws, such as the Page Act of 1875 and the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882. The Act excluded Chinese skilled and unskilled laborers and Chinese employed in mining from entering the country for 10 years under penalty of imprisonment and deportation, as well as denying U.S. citizenship to Chinese immigrants. The act effectively began immigration enforcement at the border because prior to the passage of the Page Act and Chinese Exclusion Act, there existed no trained officials and interpreters, nor the bureaucratic machinery with which to enforce immigration restriction laws or an effort to document and track the movements and familial relationships of immigrants. These types of policies implemented in the Page and Chinese Exclusion Acts have largely been seen as due to what Erica Lee depicts as government officials' deep suspicion Chinese were attempting to enter the country under fraudulent pretenses. The Act, the original Exclusion Act of 1882, only excluded Chinese laborers for a period of 10 years following the Exclusion Act of 1882 and other amendments, such as the documentary requirement. Changing 1884 amendment, efforts were sought to crack down on illegal entry and residence of Chinese in the U.S. When the 1882 Act expired in 1892, Californian Democratic Senator Thomas Geary sponsored the Act's renewal, and so the extension provision was named after him. The Geary Act, besides renewing the exclusion of Chinese laborers for another 10 years, also outlined provisions that required Chinese already in the U.S. to possess certificates of residence, as well as certificates of identity after the McCreary Amendment was added that served as proof that they entered the U.S. legally and had the right to remain in the country. The certificates of residence contained the name, age, local residence, occupation, and photograph of the applicant. The act placed the burden of proof of their right to be in the U.S. on the Chinese themselves, denied bail to Chinese in habeas corpus proceedings, made it the duty of all Chinese laborers in the U.S. to apply within 1 year for a certificate of residence, with a duplicate kept in the office of the Collector of Internal Revenue, and suitable penalties were prescribed for any falsification of certificates. Another of the Act's provisions required 2 white witnesses to testify to a Chinese person's immigration status if any Chinese laborer within the United States without this certificate of residence was deemed and adjudged to be unlawfully in the United States. They could be arrested and forced to do hard labor, and be deported after a year. This was the first time ever illegal immigration to the U.S. was made punishable by such a harsh degree. Even though this act seems to have granted no concessions to Chinese immigrants whatsoever, historians such as Elmer Clarence Sandmeyer have noted that many Californians were disappointed that the act did not achieve total exclusion, although the act stated that these certificates, as well as similar certificates of identity later created by the then newly formed Bureau of Immigration to document all Chinese who were actually exempt from the exclusion and subsequent Geary Acts, for example merchants, teachers, travelers, and students, were supposed to serve as indubitable proof of legal entry, the documents did not function to protect legal immigrants and residents from government harassment as Erica Lee describes, because the act required all Chinese to possess the certificates. The entire Chinese community in the U.S., including immigrants and residents who were supposed to be exempt from the exclusionary laws, was exposed to the same level of constraint and inquiry governing Chinese laborers. The motivation behind this unprecedented level of inquiry, says Lee, was quite bluntly due to the prejudiced view that it was, as Senator Geary himself stated, impossible to identify Chinamen. No other immigrant group were required to hold documents proving their lawful residence until 1928, when immigrant identification cards were first issued to any new immigrant arriving for permanent residence. These were replaced by green cards, officially alien registration receipt cards, after 1940, a fact that Lee calls gatekeeping and sees as rooted in a Western American desire to sustain white supremacy. In a multiracial West reaction, the Los Angeles Herald strongly supported the act and its certification provision, stating in an editorial that nearly all civilized nations have had until lately a very rigid system of passports in which a very exact personal description of the bearer formed a part. Within a few months of the implementing the act, Chinese in the U.S. began organizing to resist the enforcement of the law. The heads of the six companies, the San Francisco branch of the Chinese Consolidated Benevolent Association, proclaimed that the Chinese in the U.S. ought not register, but rather contribute to a fund for hiring of lawyers to fight the law on the ground of unconstitutionality. The effort was overwhelmingly successful. Only 3,169 of the estimated 110,000 Chinese in the country had registered by the April 1893 deadline, yet newspaper coverage of the protest reported Chinese as being slaves to doing whatever the six companies told them to do. Resistance came from outside the west of the country as well. The Chinese Equal Rights League in New York and Brooklyn pleaded that its members to help their fellow countrymen, and enrolled some 150 English-speaking Chinese merchants and professionals in New York. Its leaders argued that by making Chinese immigrants pay the illegal costs and expenses of enforcing the law, the bill imposed taxation without representation. The Chinese Equal Rights League was able to gain much support from whites on the East Coast, as on September 22, 1892, more than 1,000 U.S. citizens joined some 200 Chinese merchants and laborers at Cooper Union in Manhattan to protest the Geary Act. Several Chinese that refused to register for their certificate of residence brought suit that, upon appeal, was brought before the Supreme Court in Fong Yu Ting v. United States. Among some of the questions brought before the court was whether the act violated the 1868 Burlingame Treaty with China, whether hard labor and deportation constituted cruel and unusual punishment and thus violated the Eighth Amendment, whether the act violated Fifth and Sixth Amendments protections by permitting imprisonment with hard labor without prior indictment or jury trial, whether the act violated the 14th Amendment's prohibition against the taking of property or liberty without due process. Among other issues, the court's 5-3 decision, delivered by Justice Horace Gray, ruled that if the U.S. as a sovereign nation had the power to exclude any person or any race it wished, it also must be able to deport any person or race it wished, and thus upheld the Geary Act. Upon hearing the decision, the Chinese consulate, the six companies, and many Chinese in the U.S. stated that they refused to pay their way back to China if deported, thus leaving the U.S. government financially responsible. The Chinese government also informed the U.S. that if it acted on the law, it would end all relations, diplomatic and economic, with the U.S. Additionally, since Congress did not write any provisions granting money to pay for, and thus enforce, deportations, the act as was rendered moot until it was amended through the McCreary Amendment, named after the senator who proposed it to appease the Chinese government, but did so only by providing an additional 6 months for Chinese to register for the residency certificates. Even with the amendment, Congress only appropriated several hundred thousand dollars to the law's enforcement. Despite the U.S. Supreme Court's ruling on the constitutionality of the law, there were practical problems with implementation nationally. Only 13,242 Chinese laborers registered, about 14% of those subject to the law. The cost of arresting and deporting as many as 85,000 unregistered Chinese was estimated at more than $7 million, but Congress had authorized only $60,000 and failed to provide a mechanism for deportation within the Geary Act. When N.Y. Look, a Chinese Civil War veteran, was arrested in New York for failure to register, Judge Emil Henry Lacombe of the U.S. Circuit Court in the Southern District of New York, ruled in re N.Y. Look that there were no deportation provisions in the law and Look could not be detained indefinitely, therefore he should be released. These problems led to the passage of an amendment, known as the McCreary Amendment, which provided an additional 6 months for Chinese to register, as well as additional restrictions such as photographs on the registration certificates. See also Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882, Chinese Immigration Act of 1885, Canada. The Chinese Immigration Act, 1923, Canada Magnuson Act, Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965, Burlingame Treaty, Scott Act 1888, Fong Yu Ting v. United States. References. Carrot, The Story of California from the Earliest Days to the Present, Chicago, A.C. McClurg. Carrot Lee, Erica at America's Gates, PG 42. Carrot Lee, Erica at America's Gates, PG 42. Carrot Alien Registration Act of 1940. Carrot Lee, Erica at America's Gates, PG 46. Carrot Editorials, Los Angeles Herald 38-25-6, May 1892. Retrieved the 14th of November 2016. The President yesterday signed the Chinese Exclusion Bill. It was not what the people of California wanted that was embodied in the Geary Bill. This last measure, however, was by no means without its effect. It compelled the conservative Senate to insert a provision compelling all Chinamen in the United States to take out certificates. This provision seems to have attracted the special wrath of Congressman Hitt. He says that it is the first time in the history of civilized nations that it has been found necessary to tag men like dogs. This sapient individual seems to have forgotten that nearly all civilized nations have had until lately a very rigid system of passports in which a very exact personal description of the bearer formed a part. This certificate feature of the new bill is the only gain over its predecessor, and we may thank Congressman Geary for forcing the concession. Carrot Lucy Sollier, Laws Harsh as Tigers, Chinese Immigrants and the Shaping of Modern Immigration Law, 46-48. Carrot Notes on Recent Decisions, Minnesota Law Journal Volume 1, No. 4 of August 1893, 86. Carrot In Re N.Y. Look, C.C. New York 1893, 56 Fed 81, Notes on Recent Decisions, Minnesota Law Journal Volume 1, No. 4 of August 1893, 86. The N.Y. Look Case, Washington Post, May 28, 1893, p4, The N.Y. Look Test Case. New York Times, May 26, 1893, p4. Carrot Anna Pegler Gordon, In Sight of America, Photography and the Development of U.S. Immigration Policy. Berkeley, University of California Press, 2009. Gabriel J. Chin, Chai Chan Ping and Fong Yu Ting, The Origins of Plenary Power, In Immigration Law. Stories. David Martin and Peter Shuck, eds, Foundation Press 2005. The Story of California from the Earliest Days to the Present, Chicago, A.C. McClurg. E. Chinese American Topics. Related Groups. Chinese Americans. American-born Chinese. Taiwanese American. Hong Kong Americans. Asian American. Hyphenated American. Hakka Americans. Hokkien and Hoklo Americans. Fuzhou Americans. History. Chinese American History by Location. California. Los Angeles. San Francisco. Hawaii. Illinois. Chicago. Massachusetts. Boston. Michigan. Detroit. Missouri. St. Louis. New York. New York City. Puerto Rico. Texas. Dallas. Fort Worth. Houston. Washington. Seattle. Anti-Chinese Discrimination Legislation. Anti-Chinese Legislation. Anti-Cooley Act. Chinese Exclusion Act. Geary Act. Immigration Act of 1924. Cable Act. Magnuson Act. Immigration and Nationality Act of 1965. Events. Chinese Massacre of 1871. Tape v. Hurley 1884. Issaquah Riot of 1885. Rock Springs Massacre 1885. Tacoma Riot of 1885. Seattle Riot of 1886. Yikuo v. Hopkins 1886. Hell's Canyon Massacre 1887. United States v. Wong Kim Ark 1898. Murder of Vincent Chin 1982. Indictment of Peter Liang 2016. Chinatowns. Chinatowns in the Americas. Chinatowns in the United States. Chinatowns in Canada. Chinatowns in Latin America. Baltimore. Boston. Chicago. Cleveland. Denver. Detroit. Honolulu. Houston. Southwest. East. Downtown. Locke, California. Los Angeles. Monterey Park, California. Montville, Connecticut. Newark. New Jersey. New Orleans. New York City. Manhattan. Brooklyn. Queens. Oakland. Philadelphia. Phoenix. Pittsburgh. Portland. Maine. Portland. Oregon. Providence. Rhode Island. Richardson, Texas. Rockville. Maryland. St. Louis. Salt Lake City. San Diego. San Francisco. Richmond District, Sunset District, San Gabriel Valley, San Jose, California, Seattle, Spokane, Washington, Stockton, California, Tacoma, Washington, Washington, D.C. Culture, food, American Chinese cuisine, film, American Chinese films, terminology, Chinaman's chants, juke, sing, events. Love Boat, Education, Chinese School, Confucius Institute, Transportation, Chinatown, Bus Lines, Museums, Museum of Chinese in America, Chinese American Museum, Cam Wa Chung, Chinese Society, Halls on Maui, Ying on Association, Chinese Staff and Workers Association, Chinese for Affirmative Action Committee of 100, Organization of Chinese Americans, Bing Kong Tong, Hip Sing Association, Banks, Cathay Bank, United International Bank, Global Commerce Bank, East West Bank, Others Lists, List of Chinese Americans, List of U.S. cities with significant Chinese American populations.